Monday, June 1st, emergency alerts sent to protesters' cell phones told them curfew started at 7 p.m. So when U.S. Park Police and officers from several other federal agencies pushed through and used tear gas about 6:30 near Lafayette Square Park, several hundred protesters were shocked. Forced to leave, the largest group of protesters tried to first march towards the U.S. Capitol, but police blocked them. Protesters faced low-flying National Guard helicopters in Chinatown before heading towards DuPont Circle. Protester Kyle Murphy noticed how D.C. Metropolitan Police appeared to be corralling protesters north.
Throughout that night, D.C. police were kind of playing the role of both corralling, containing, and also trying to escort protesters.
Rahul Dubey, living in a row house on 15th and Swan Street Northwest, began to notice an increased police presence before 9 p.m.
I went for a quick walk, and 10 minutes later, I came back, and there were 90 officers and military officials and Metro Police on the corner of Swan and 15th for no apparent reason.
Dubey, Murphy, and others tell WSA9 they witnessed MPD closing off residential streets, guiding the protest towards one destination. A WSA9 crew was there at 8:58 p.m. when the protesters met a line of police compelling them to turn onto Swan Street. The lid was put onto the kettle. By 9:08, there was no way out.
A couple people had asked me how they could get out. I'm like, there's get out. I mean, look at the street. It's barricaded in. It's a fortress.
Jorge Fuentes was one of those protesters kettled into Swan Street.
Honestly, I'm feeling a lot of fear, adrenaline, trying to get my friends out of there, feeling guilty for putting them in that situation, and honestly, just being treated like a criminal.
I was here with my 20-year-old daughter, making sure that she knows that no matter what's going on, that you have to continue to fight for what you believe in.
I didn't see sympathy or empathy, honestly. I thought to myself, who do you protect?
At 9:32 p.m., there was police pepper spray. There was pushing and shoving. There was running and resistance. There was chaos on Swan Street when MPD began mass arrests. Rahul Dubey took 74 protesters into his home. 194 protesters did not make it inside.
When I walked in that house, I saw pepper spray in my living room permeating through the entire house, milk flying, baking soda flying, and a 6'9", 280 black man in the fetal position rocking back and forth crying.
Kettling is a police tactic familiar to MPD. From 2002, when D.C. Council found wrongful arrests when MPD confronted anti-globalization protests at Pershing Park, to lawsuits alleging kettling in 2017 during Inauguration Day protests.
We were monitoring a group that was exhibiting behaviors that was consistent with the behavior that preceded very violent events in our city the prior two nights. Some of that behavior was the throwing of different projectiles and also the burning of a Metropolitan Police Department police vehicle.
Our news crew and witnesses did not report seeing any acts of violence or vandalism coming from that particular group of hundreds of protesters in the minutes before they were kettled into Swan Street. Neither MPD nor the police union replied to us for comment, so we went to an expert in the field of riot control.
The challenges of having a police force surgically go in, grab who they want, take them out of a very active situation, is that even possible?
You described a situation that's similar to what the U.S. military had to do overseas in their operations to try to almost cherry pick people, not knowing who the real combatants were and then who the ones that were not, who the civilians were. I don't know if that's reasonable or not. I don't know if that's a reasonable expectation to think our police can do that.
The D.C. Attorney General's office says they're still deciding which of the 194 Swan Street protester arrests to prosecute. Arraignment dates are delayed until October due to the pandemic. Police Chief Newsham says MPD's actions on Swan Street are under internal review. We noticed the American flag, seemingly hanging by a thread from the second floor of Rahul's home.
I tied a piece of string to it and I tossed it out my window as a protest to the fact that we're extremely fragile. And one day later, boom, this was a symbol for safety for a lot of people that were out there.